students, welcome to the class of English literature. Today we are going to discuss a poem written by A.K. Ramanujan. The title of the poem is Ecology. A.K. Ramanujan was an Indian playwright, folklorist, philologist, translator, and a bilingual poet. He belonged to Mysore in India and taught in many universities of the country. He was born on 16 March 1929 and he died on 13 July 1993. A.K. Ramanujan, an Indian poet and scholar of Indian literature, wrote in both languages, English and Kannada. He migrated to America. Even though he moved to America, his poetry is primarily based on his Indian experiences and sensibility. He constantly harks back to his memories of family, local places, images, belief and history, things that remind him of home. The volumes of his poetry are The Striders, that was published in 1966, Relations, published in 1971, Selected Poems, published in 1976, Second Sight, published in 1986, and Collected Poems, that was published in 1995. Collected Poems was a posthumous publication as it was published after poet's death. In 1976, he was awarded the Padma Shri and in 1983, the MacArthur Prize Fellowship. The South Asia Council of the Association for Asian Studies has established the A.K. Ramanujan Book Prize for translation to commemorate his excellence and contribution to translation. He became a lecturer in the University of Chicago in 1962, where he worked till his death in 1993. Most of his works breathe Indian culture and tradition. He posthumously won the Sahitya Academy Award for Collected Poems in 1999. What is ecology? The title of the poem is Ecology, so we must understand the term ecology. It is a scientific term. It is a branch of science. Ecology is the study of the relationships between living organisms, including humans, and their physical environment. It seeks to understand the vital connections between plants and animals and the world around them. Ecology also provides information about the benefits of ecosystems and how we can use Earth's resources in ways that leave the environment healthy for future generation. So, ecology जो है, science की ऐसी branch है जिसमें हम study करते हैं कि living organism का उसके surrounding से, उसके environment से क्या relationship है, तो उनके बीच का जो relationship है, वो ecology के अंतर्गत study किया जाता है. Now, introduction of the poem. Ecology is Ramanujan's well-known poem. It depicts the blind and innocent faith of an Indian woman. This woman is the poet's own mother. She has great love and respect for champak trees in her yard. They have been there from the time she could remember and provided basket full of flowers to the women in the family to offer their gods. But the fragrance of the flowers gave her severe attacks of migraine and so her children decide to cut them down. When she hears about this, she flies into a fury and adamantly protests against her children. The poet implies that through her love for the trees, unaware his mother is becoming a strong spokesperson for the protection of nature and trees. And the poet himself represents the educated modern man who forgets his duty to nature. A.K. Ramanujan is devoted to his mother. He is very angry because the flowers of the red champak tree caused a severe headache to his mother. So we can see the poem shows the poet's strong interest in the family and it presents a son's devotion to his mother and mother's devotion to ecology. So it creates a kind of conflict between mother and son. Now we will read the text of the poem. The poem begins as, "The day after the first rain for years, I would come home in Irish, for I could see from a mile away, or three red champak trees had done it again, had burst into flower and given my mother her first blinding migraine of the season, with their street long heavy hung, yellow pollen fog of a fragrance no wind could shift." The poet says that for a number of years, he wants to say that it is happening for a number of years, यानी काफ़ी सालों से ये होता आ रहा है. ड्यूरिंग एवरी फर्स्ट रेन ही फाइंड्स हिज मदर सफरिंग फ्रॉम ए ब्लाइंडिंग माइग्रेन, दैट मीन अनबियरेबल हेडेक बिकॉज ऑफ थ्री रेड चंपक ट्रीज. ड्यूरिंग द समर सीजन द रेड चंपक ट्रीज फ्लावर ब्लूम विच देन रिलीज येल्लो पोलन ग्रेन्स इन द ईयर विच अकॉर्डिंग टू द पॉइंट स्प्रेड लाइक क्लाउड्स थ्रू आउट द स्ट्रीट. The pollen grains remain suspended in the air and thus do not allow the wind to get pure. It remains filled with their fragrance. These pollen grains have made the air thick like fog. In fact, the air is yellow with its heady scent and the breeze cannot blow away this fog. It remains filled with their fragrance. So poet says, the day after the first rain for years, I would come home in Irish. यानी जब फर्स्ट रेन के बाद बहुत सालों से ऐसा हो रहा है. व्हेन आई कम होम इन रेज इन एंगर, गुस्से में मैं घर पे आता हूँ. और व्हाट इज़ द रीज़न ऑफ दिस एंगर ही टेल्स, फॉर आई कुड सी फ्रॉम ए माइल अवे, एक मील दूरी से ही मैं इस बात को देख सकता हूँ. और थ्री रेड चंपक ट्रीज हैड डन इट अगेन, कि हमारे घर के जो तीन रेड चंपक के पेड़ हैं उन्होंने दोबारा से ये कर दिया. What they had done again, they had burst into flower, कि उनके फूल दोबारा से खिल गए हैं. And given mother her first blinding migraine of the season, और उन्होंने सीजन का मदर को पहला ब्लाइंडिंग माइग्रेन दे दिया है. It seems that mother is suffering from this migraine during the whole season, यानी पूरे सीजन के दौरान मदर जो है वो माइग्रेन से सफ़र करती है इन फूलों की वजह से. With their street long heavy hung yellow pollen fog of a fragrance, यानी ये pollen grains जो है इतने ज़्यादा densely वहाँ air में है, that air is looking like a fog, मतलब वहाँ एक fog की तरह वो फैले हुए हैं उनकी fragrance. And no wind could shift, और हवा भी जो है उसको वहाँ से move नहीं कर पा रही है. So it remains filled with the fragrance, हर जगह जो फ्रेग्रेंस है वो चंपक ट्री के पोलन ग्रेन्स की है. पार्ट फर्दर सीज, नो डोर कुड शट आउट फ्रॉम आवर ब्लैक पिलर्ड हाउस हुज वॉल्स हैड ईयर्स एंड आईज स्केल्स स्मेल्स बोन क्रिक्स नाइटली विस्टिंग वॉइसेस एंड वर पोरस लाइक अस. इन द नेक्स्ट लाइन द पार्ट सीज दैट नो डोर कैन शट आउट, means no door can prevent the pollens from entering into their black pillared house, यानी कोई भी दरवाज़ा जो है pollen grains की जो fragrance है उसको घर के अंदर आने से नहीं रोक पा रहा. Doors cannot keep it out either. The whole street in front of them is thick with it. It will seep in through the gaps. According to the poet, his house walls had ears and eyes. That's why every voice, bone creaks, nightly visiting voices, they all are coming into their houses. So he wants to say that house has eyes and ears, means the poet personifies the house. He is saying that like us, it is also suffering from the bombardment of pollen grains which are coming inside it through the holes which are like the pores of human body. But mother, flashing her temper like her mother's twisted silver grandchildren's knickers, wet as the cold peck on her head, would not let us cut down a flowering tree. The poet finally tells his mother that he is going to cut the trees, which flashes rage and anger in her head, which is full of sweat and pain due to migraines. The poet compares her anger with twisted silver. either on the roof or in the balcony, which is shining because of the wet knickers of her mother's grandchildren. Here the use of simile, that mother's temper is compared with twisted silver. The use of simile gives the mother's anger some physical quality, shiny, radiant, expressive in her temper, and soaked, then wrung, wet because she was sweating. Thus, like the silver wire, his mother's head is also twisted due to sphere pain. तो यहाँ मदर जो है उसके एंगर को कंपेयर किया गया है ट्विस्टेड सिल्वर से. Would not let us cut down a flowering tree, but mother will not allow them to cut down that tree which is providing them flowers. Almost as old as her, she said by passing birds providential droppings to give her gods and her daughters and daughters' daughters basket full of annual flower, and for one line of cousins a door of migraines in season. The poet desires to cut it, but his mother stops him from doing so. For her, the tree is a good omen. Its flowers are offered to gods and goddesses by the time of her marriage. She tells the poet that the tree is as old as she is, almost as old as her. Its seed was seeded by passing birds' providential dropping. Providential dropping means it was dropped, the seeds were dropped by passing bird, and which is a sign of good omen, taken as a blessing because it came from the sky. She believes that the bird seeded the plants so that a line of cousins, or in other words, each new generation, may be able to offer its basket full of annual flowers to God. And for this reason, she is all prepared to bear the pain of migraine. In the last line of the poem, and for one line of cousins, a door of migraine in season. Here poet wants to say that perhaps the pollen allergy is inherited. It is causing, the flowers will cause migraine to further generation, future generation also. So we can conclude that the poet has tried to show the difference in the views of people belonging to old generation like mother and those belonging to new generation like poet. The old people have emotions, memories, beliefs, etc. attached to the ecology. For the poet, the red champak tree have no use. The pollens pollute the air and thus the city. सो फर्स्ट थिंग, अगर हम इस पोएम की थीम देखें तो यहाँ डिफरेंस बताया गया है थिंकिंग में, कि ओल्ड जनरेशन और न्यू जनरेशन हैं उनके थिंकिंग में डिफरेंस है. ओल्डर जनरेशन जो है उनमें एक इमोशन है, एक लगाव है इकोलॉजी को लेके, जबकि न्यू जनरेशन जो है वो इस चीज़ को नहीं देख पा रही हैं. सेकेंडली, द एक्चुअल मीनिंग ऑफ द वर्ड इकोलॉजी इज़ नॉट फॉलोड हियर. But the poet seems to convey the thought that a particular kind of tree may have both negative and positive factors. ये ecology का जो actual meaning होता है कि ecology जो है वो plants का और animals का उनके surrounding से relationship के बारे में बताया जाता है इसमें. So here poet is not just trying to talk about ecology, he wants to convey message that a particular kind of tree may have both negative and positive factors, and therefore it need not be pulled down. The poem is also about a son's devotion to his mother and mother's devotion to ecology. That creates a kind of conflict between the two. यानी mother और son में एक तरह का conflict यहाँ दिखाया गया है इस poem में. The poem can be read either as a single sentence or in stanzas. There is no proper dividation of stanzas in the poem, so we can also read the poem as a single sentence. There is no rhyme scheme in the poem. Poem is written in free verse. The poet has used a number of literary devices in the poem, like metaphor is used, personification, simile, etc. So it's a great poem. Thank you.